South by Southwest is where tech, music, and film come together. So of course brands are here trying to wedge themselves into the conversation. Downtown Austin turns into this bizarre place where coffee shops and restaurants are taken over by Samsung and McDonald's, and even the pedicabs are sponsored by HBO. I got a firsthand look at what the companies are doing this year and got to see the most ridiculous, most successful, and the laziest brand activations, which is the dumbest word ever, but means that companies are trying to engage people here who otherwise wouldn't care about them at all. I just saw the most South by Southwest thing I've ever seen at South by Southwest. An Austin startup called Knack partnered with Del Monte to break the world record for most people dressed as fruit. The standing world record is 629, and Knack wants to break it with a nice round 680. Knack is a social media advertising company that connects Snapchat influencers and people who are super popular on Instagram with brands that would want to pay them to promote their products. Knack just launched an iOS app that lets everyone do the same thing. So even if you don't have a million Instagram followers, you can still find your favorite brands and maybe they'll pay you a few bucks to promote them in your feed. Knack decided to celebrate the launch of the app with this party, which brought out Snapchat stars and hundreds of people who were guaranteed to share photos and videos from this ridiculous event. Once Knack had the idea for the event, they, of course, reached out to Del Monte, which happened to have hundreds of banana costumes on hand, which was obviously a match made in heaven. Knack achieved what it set out to do. Not only did it break the world record for most people dressed as fruit in one room, but it also got all of these people amplifying the brand, sharing photos and videos, which is what every company comes to South by Southwest to do. Next up was the Gatorade Fuel Lab. I didn't know what to expect when I walked into Gatorade's Fuel Lab, and the first thing that was handed to me was a pair of VR goggles and a headset. So I got to be playing football, working out, and of course, drinking Gatorade. Then we walked into a room where we got a preview of what Gatorade's working on right now, which is a sweat patch that analyzes your sweat to figure out what you need in terms of calories and electrolytes. Then Gatorade uses that information, which is communicated digitally, to create specialized Gatorade just for you. It has everything you need in it to keep you hydrated and increase your performance while you're working out. Then it's gonna ship those pods to you and you just put them in the smart cap, which attaches to your bottle. The cap will even light up when it knows you need to drink more. The best part was walking into a room where I got to customize my own Gatorade bottle. I got to pick the color, the cap pattern, it has my name on it. This thing is amazing and I can't wait to use it. This is what brands need to do at South by Southwest to really draw people in and not just act like they're here just because. My biggest takeaway from this experience was the level of personalization. I really felt like this was customized just for me. And it kind of was. In 2014, there were lines around the block to see HBO's Game of Thrones exhibit because it was a virtual reality experience where you got to actually be one of the characters. Last year, it wasn't quite as cool, but you got to use a sword to create an art installation piece, which, you know, that's fun. This year, things took a turn for the worse. This year, South by Southwestros has been turned into the Hall of Faces, which is a key plot point in the season, but it's really not that cool. You take a picture of yourself with an iPad, and that picture then goes onto the wall. It takes a couple minutes to show up, and sometimes it doesn't even show up properly. Taking a photo of yourself with an iPad, I mean, anybody could do that. Game of Thrones is such a cool show that HBO could have done so much more. This just felt lazy. The award for most adorable brand presence at South by Southwest, hands down, goes to Mophie, because it was the only company in Austin with St. Bernard puppies. So you might be wondering, what do Mophies have to do with puppies? Well, it's a marketing stunt, of course. If your phone is dying at South by Southwest and you tweet at the company with the hashtag Mophie Rescue, if you're lucky enough, a St. Bernard might come bring you a free Mophie battery pack. It's basically the cutest marketing stunt ever. But this wasn't just Mophie shilling its own products. It was also to benefit the St. Bernard Rescue Foundation. A few of these puppies were adopted and hopefully they went to really good homes. It was a win-win-win. Mophie got to advertise its products, People got free battery packs, and everyone got to see cute St. Bernard puppies. What could be better? South by Southwest is cool. Brands are not cool, but they're here hoping some of that coolness rubs off on them. Sometimes it works, like with Gatorade's Fuel Lab. Other times, not so much, like with Game of Thrones. And sometimes it's just so ridiculous that you can't help but have fun. Companies have poured so much money into South by Southwest and made it so over the top that I actually can't imagine the festival without them.